Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree and today we have to see how to set up this Spring framework in your Windows machine. So without any further ado, let's quickly get started. First of all, open your choice browser and then first remember we require three things to run the Spring project. So first of all, we require some software. So we choose here Eclipse IDE. Then secondly, we require some logging jars, and third, we require some Spring framework jars. If we have these three conditions, these three setups, then you are good to go to run the Spring project. So first of all, you have to search the Eclipse IDE download for Windows 10 or your Linux machine. So as per your OS, you have to check here. So I require Eclipse for Windows and just click on the download button. You can search the Windows Eclipse IDE download, and then here is the first website, which is Eclipse download and the Eclipse foundation, and here the website link is https://www.eclipse.org. This is the official website, so just click on this Eclipse button. Once you click on this Eclipse button, that link, then you have to show the icon download at 64-bit machine, Eclipse for 64-bit machine. So just click on this. Now here is the download button option. So just click on this. And here, thank you for your download. So your download should be started. First of all, it asked you where you have to download that. Here is the path. So just click on the save button and your download should be successfully started. You can see here is the download should be started. It takes some moments, and once the download should be completed, then we can see what should we have to do. So here our download should be successfully completed. You can see. So just double click on this. Once you double click on this, so here is the option run. So click on run option. Then you guys are able to see there are so many versions available for different platforms and different development. So first option is Eclipse IDE for Java developers, then for enterprise Java and web developers, then C++ developer, embedded C++ developers, PHP developers, Eclipse committers, then Java and DSL developers, RCP and RAP developers, modeling tools and Scout developers. So many options are available. So for Spring, you have to install the first option or second option. If you install the first option for Java developers, then you are able to do the basic program or basic projects of Spring framework. But if you want MVC and exception handling type programs, then you require enterprise Java and web developers. So we choose the second, because in this both simple as well as advanced programs are enabled. So simply click on Eclipse and Eclipse for enterprise Java and web developer and just click on install. Installation should be started, and once this installation should be completed, then you are able to see here is the Eclipse IDE for enterprise Java and web developer shortcut should be created. Simply double click on this. Here is the directory as a workspace. This is the default directory, but if you want to change the workspace, then you have to, here is the browse option, so you can change that, but I remains the default. So click on launch. Then you can see here is the ID available for Spring development. So how to create the project and all, we can see in the next video, but currently we can create install the Eclipse IDE for Spring. So first step should be done. Then we have to navigate to second step. For that, we have to download the logging jars which are required for Spring. So simply search logging jars. Once you, then here Apache Commons website should be here, and here download Apache Commons logging. So simply click on this. Once you click on this, then just scroll down the page and you are able to see here are some binaries, some source code, some archives. So we download from here common loggings zip file or bin file. So we download here a bin file. Just click on this, and you can see here where you want to save this option. So simply save, and here is the installation should be started. Once your installation should be complete, then we can see here is the folder. Open that, double click on this common logging jars folder, double click, and here you are able to see here are some jars available for common logins. So you have to use these jars in your Eclipse IDE. So you just import these jars, and this is all about logging jars. We're done with our second step. So now simply the third step, which is we have to download the Spring Framework jars. So search here Spring Framework jars. So here is the first option, https://docs.spring.io. This is the official website. Click on this. Once you click on this, there are too many options are available for you. You can see here is a 1.2.3 and all, then 3.0.3 up to. You can able to see here are so many options, so many. 6.2. Almost 7. Up to 7th version of these jars are available. So as per our need, we have to download. We download here any type of jar. So you have to simply click on this, and then your download should be started. And once your download should be completed, then you can see here are the jars available. These all the jars are downloaded, and we simply copy this jar in a single folder because they are easily accessible or easily import in your program. So that's all. We're done with our three steps, and once you done with your three steps, you are able to do the Spring Framework projects and development. So, and yeah, this is all about today's video. I hope this video is little bit helpful for you. If yes, then please do like to this video, also share it with your friends, and if you haven't subscribed, then do subscribe. Also hit the bell icon, because whenever I upload any video, then you got the first notification. And thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned for next video. Bye.